School and Dulwich College dynasty. They have won it the last 3 years. They're going four in a row. Only one other school has ever done this in the past. That was Colston's Collegiate back in the 90s. Nobody's done four in a row. But Dulwich will be looking to go into uncharted territory for schools rugby to try and pick up a fourth cup crown in 4 years. Bromsgrove stand in their way day, and we watched up the Lions Park and I was mightily impressed by them.
Well, both teams just making their way out now, and both packs are going to have a huge part to play today. We saw them use the driving ball, we saw them use the set piece, both to fantastic effect. They used it to get field position, they used it to get to score tries. I think that particular movement is going to have a massive, massive part to play too. There are great individuals on display, but the units are going to make the difference.
Bromsgrove School against Dulwich College. This is the NatWest Schools Cup for Under-18s Cup Final. Bromsgrove are here in their droves. Dulwich are here as always. Big pack separated into two sections this year. Usually to one big pack in the corner. Bromsgrove, to their credit, there's plenty of them here too. Bromsgrove team, a couple of changes being made here. Ferguson, Walker, Brett Cutting making way for Joe Morris, who moves to seven in place of Henry Lloyd-Jones. Clegg, five. Sheeman, six. Ford, Teresi White, Bent, Nisbet, Edward Staunton and Taylor of the Bromsgrove School. Show you Dulwich School, and we have a moment. Our referee, Christoph Ridley, is the man in the middle and gets us underway. Bromsgrove in their maroon tops, Dulwich as always in their blue and black. Pierre Thompson, the scrum half, with the box kick, and he has a good one as well. Good take by Tom Ford. Parisi, Luke White, Parisi again, White, Alex Nisbet, Chase Edwards, caught off guard, but still they have possession. Not for long, the ball was knocked forward and Dulwich will have the footing.
It's going to be a real, real battle this one, and the early exchanges could play a key part in here as both teams look to impose themselves on the game. Who's going to win the physical battle? No one's going to want to take a backward step. Bromsgrove looking to put a bit of width on it there, but the winger just overrunning the pass, which within the first minute gives us a scrum to have a look at.
Dulwich School, Wichelow, Derome, Andrew Barron, Luke Bliss, Charlie D, Tom Watling coming in for Ed Norris, Sam Younger, Tom Marchant, the captain, Pierre Thompson, John Waugh, Reece Pinnock, three tries in the semi-final, Ed Berry, Hugh Roberts, Omar Malik and Anthony Unzigwu coming in for Ralph Marchant. Two changes for Dulwich from their semi-final victory. And out of interest, of the Dulwich 15, seven of them were here 12 months ago.
Well, experience at this level is absolutely key. One of the names that really stands out there, Reece Pinnock. He was absolute grease lightning in the semi-final. So difficult to stop with ball in hand.
This reminds you, of course, 35 minutes a half at this level. Dulwich College only entered this competition in 2012. They've never lost a match. Thompson goes to ground and an early penalty of the tackler not rolling away, and a chance for Dulwich to gain some ground. What are you expecting here, Dave? Because one thing we were impressed by, me and you, were Bromsgrove and especially their pack. I thought they were superb in that semi-final.
Well, all the talk is about the Dulwich dynasty, as you put it, and that's exactly what it is. As you say, they've never lost a game in the competition, but all the chat in the under-15s bars was about Tyrese Johnson-Fisher, but it was actually the other number 13 that ran away with the headlines. Nick Jonas got man of the match there, so this is a real opportunity for Bromsgrove to do the same. They were hugely impressive in the semi-final. And they'll be coming into this match brimming with confidence, but knowing that Dulwich are such a danger. You don't get a record like them without being a first-class operation.
Bromsgrove have it inside the 9-22, looking to clear their lines. Parisi. The box kick downfield. Dulwich look to launch the counter-attack. Thompson. First mistake from Dulwich, knocking advantage coming Bromsgrove way. And they'll have that right now, in fact, on the halfway line.
Couple of minutes in, teams both feeling each other out at the moment, no one really catching the eye, either as an individual or as a team. Bit of a midfield battle. Couple of mistakes too. A lot at stake here today. This is, well, really, without question, the biggest match in school rugby. One of the premier stadiums, premier sports arenas in the world. Chance to be a hero if ever there was one.
Parisi with a footing, collects. White. Again, a little bit loose, a little bit nervous. Ball went backwards, so we carry on playing. Luke White, the Bromsgrove captain, goes to ground. Parisi spots a gap. And gains a few yards with a bit of help from his friends. Still, they're continuing to drive forward. This is something that we spotted in their semi-final and some one of their attacking strengths. Advantage here for Dulwich, and that may be for the knock-on. Certainly is. They'll have the put in 5 minutes now.
Error-strewn beginning, which is understandable. So both of these teams will be looking to cut that out. If one team can really take a stranglehold and start playing some mistake-free rugby, and that could be the difference.
Thompson with the putting. Thompson. John Wall. Ed Berry. Thompson, box kick is blocked, but it's still in Dulwich's hands. I do beg your pardon, it's gone, been turned over to Bromsgrove. First mistake from Dulwich. Parisi, kicked down here by Luke Bent. And how's the bounce here? It's pretty good, in fact.
Yeah, excellent kick. Change of the direction as well. The ball came left from the base of the ruck. Just checked back inside and knocked it over to the right-hand side. Pressure on Dulwich here to clear their lines. Excellent kick. Really clever play. Let's have a look at the replay there. Great ball out to the 10. Dabs it over the top. Turns the winger who can't do anything about it, Reese Pinnock. And here comes the line out.
Richard DeRome. Good collection by Charlie D, but as we said, not straight, scrum down. Bromsgrove with the foot in, and this is where they're dangerous, Dave.
Yeah, this is a big chance. Few uncharacteristic mistakes from Dulwich. Few knock-ons in midfield.
Very quickly, these are the replacements for both the teams. Lockhart, Carton, Weston, Hans, Tibbetts, George and Edwards for Bromsgrove, and for Dulwich, Akizi, Clifford, Holly, Osuntoken, Norris, Bannister, Annoy and Glove. Parisi, White, Bromsgrove on the run, Roberts, Edwards, Parisi, Clegg, Parisi, White, picked up by Ferguson, Parisi spots a gap, excellent tackle there from Tom Watling. Parisi, White, kick out wide. Ball has gone backwards, but it's on the run, and there's going to be a chance here for Reece Pinnock. The ball has been called back, called the play back. Referee spotted a knock on. It's got scrum down, and it is Bromsgrove ball.
Yeah, I think that's gone forward off Pinnock. Crossfield kick there. It was a good option, but Pinnock read it, but couldn't quite execute the catch over on the far side. Let's have a look at the replay here. Yeah, Pinnock there, thought he was away. It was a great cover tackle from Taylor. He wasn't to know that the ball had been knocked on and the referee's whistle had gone. Again, positive stuff from Bromsgrove, forcing the play one way, then trying to work it right via the boot. But this is another great opportunity from the scrum.
Parisi with the putting. Again, good scrum. White. Bromsgrove on the run. Bent. Thornton. Parisi. White. Parisi. White again. Taylor. Taylor staying strong, 5 metres out. Parisi goes to his right very quickly. Could be a chance here for Luke White. Good tackle from Pinnock. Keeps it in play with Harrison Hook. Parisi. Walker. Go left, they're going to have a chance. White. Parisi. Morris. Parisi. Walker. That's how far short they are. About a metre out. Parisi. Clegg. Chance here for Brett Cutting. It's over. What a start for Bromsgrove.
Well, over on the far side, it looks like the whole school is here and they have erupted as the try has gone over. Ever since that little dab over the top into the corner for the line-out, Bromsgrove have been on top and they've got their just desserts there. The second row are powering over following some patient phase play. The hooker going so close there, being put through the gap. But it was great defence from Dulwich right up until that point. But eventually the wall crumbled and through came Bromsgrove to take a deserved lead in this cup final.
5-0, the lead. Difficult kick here for Luke White, the captain. But this was 7-0. And a beautiful start. The team from the Midlands. Oh, right in the heart. Right in the heart. A superb kick. Superb kick from Luke White. 7-0 Bromsgrove lead. What a start.
Yeah, excellent kick from the outside half. We had a great view of that from our commentary position. Never in doubt from the moment it left his right boot.
Ed Betty with the restart. Good tackle from Tom Watling. On Cooper Bent. Parisi with the box kick. Collected by John Wall. Wall gets from one man and another, and he's still going up towards the 22. Tackled by Chase Edwards. And Bromsgrove win the penalty. And have a chance to clear from their own 22. Dulwich haven't come to the races in this first 12 minutes.
No, they need to try and get some sort of composure, some sort of foothold in the game. It's not something they've been able to do so far. Bromsgrove just getting the better of things at the moment. whenever it goes to the breakdown, they seem to be on the front foot. They seem to be able to force the mistake. And Dulwich not being able to sustain anything at this stage of the match. But still, we're not even halfway through the first half yet. A long, long way to go in this final.
13 minutes have been played. Excellent take from Justin Clegg. In the hands of Ben Shearmond. And this is what we saw this last time. This is what they're good at, Bromsgrove. This is their trump card.
Well, that's 15 metres made already.
And they've got a penalty as well to come.
20 metres.
Parisi. White. Went for the drop goal, but he's got the penalty already in his pocket. And a good example there, Dave, of what Bromsgrove are good at. And just talk us through this. Excellent rugby.
Take a look at this. They set it just inside the half. And drive and drive. It's absolutely undefendable. Look at it. That's 10 metres straight away. Referee watching it like a hawk. There comes the advantage. And they keep going, keep going. Luke White, the captain, he knew the advantage was coming. That was not a great strike at the drop goal. But he's got a chance to go one better here. They're going for the sticks.
Looking to rack up the points. Luke White, this for the 10-0 lead. We'll get there. Is it online? It is. What a start for Bromsgrove. 10-0, they lead over the defending champions, Dulwich College.
Well, we said the forward battle would be key. Both teams, great discipline in the pack. They can make yards for fun with that maul. And Bromsgrove have forced the penalty in the score. Absolute dream start to the final for them.
Ball was knocked forward. So Dulwich will have a knocking advantage to come should they want it. 10-0. They trail. Thompson. War. Berry. Malik, Thompson, Watling, Wichelow, War, Thompson, Wichelow. Thompson, War, Watling, into the 22, Thompson, crossfield kick, Omar Malik under it, it's gone too far, and Bromsgrove will have the minus.
Yeah, good response there from Dulwich though, going through the phases inside the Bromsgrove 22, looking to open it up with a crossfield kick. Malik was on board, but he just overcooked it. But still, a lot of tough work for Bromsgrove here to relieve the pressure. Good territory this for Dulwich. Just what they need after conceding those 10 points in quick succession.
10-0. Sam Howard and the Dulwich coaching staff look on. Henry Walker with the line-out. Goes long, a little bit of a juggling act in the air. No knock-ons there, surprisingly. There's a couple of tippy-taps. We're all going backwards, says the referee. Thompson has it. Watling. Thompson. Inside to Omar Malik. Thompson. Wall. Thompson goes the other way. the Rome. Ed Berry, good tackle, great tackle in fact from Beck Cutton, who's had an excellent game in his first 18 or so minutes. Thompson under pressure. The referee says it's gone backwards. And Dulwich has been sent backwards. War. Sliced tackle. Out on the full, back they go. Not going Dulwich's way, and they are getting frustrated, Dave.
Yeah, they certainly are. They're just... I said it before, let's have another look at this here. This is a brilliant tackle, comes flying out of the line and absolutely cuts the inside centre off at the knees. But they're just not making brilliant rugby decisions at the moment, Dulwich. I mean, that kick was a classic example of that, sliced off the boot. You just need to calm down a bit of composure. But once again, you know, all the 50-50s going Bromsgrove's way at the moment. A misplaced line-out throw goes straight into the breadbasket of a Bromsgrove player.
Nisbet.
Oh, lovely. Oh,
Taylor. Good tackle on Cooper Bent. Parisi. White. Looking for Dulwich to launch the counter-attack from the deep. Mzigwa. Thompson. War. With a low kick. It's an awkward one. And it's kept in by White, the Bromsgrove captain. Parisi with a kick. Catches Reece Pinnock off guard, but he still collects. Pinnock. Excellent tackle from James Taylor. Thompson, War, spot a gap, ball keeps infield, didn't have the bounce, ball went backwards as the referee, as Johnny Thornton puts it up into the air, Thompson collects.
Excellent take.
Good take from Pierre Thompson, he's off and running, he's at the races, but launched into touch.
Yeah, lovely work there from Pierre Thompson, under pressure. Great take from the up and under and makes 20 or so yards then at the right touchline. Good handoff. Little moments like that are what Dulwich need, just to creep back into this game. It's not going to happen straight away. They're playing a very, very good side today. And that's the prize.
That is indeed the prize at the end of this. Taken by Joe Morris. Parisi. White. Good offload from Alex Nisbet there. Parisi. White. He's been the architect of this 10-0 lead so far. He's really orchestrating this game. Malik. Thompson. Watling. Thompson, War. What's a low one for Pinnock? Pinnock, nearly some good footballing skills from the Dulwich number 11, Reece Pinnock. Good vision.
Yeah.
Didn't happen for him.
Yeah, we spoke just a few minutes ago about Dulwich not making particularly intelligent decisions kicking wise, but ever since then, that's been the exact opposite. They've started to mix it up a bit. Bromsgrove have done that really well. They've not been scared to switch the direction of play when it's come to kicks, but Dulwich have started to go along the ground just to ask a few questions, and they find themselves in good field position here, albeit with the Bromsgrove throwing.
Bromsgrove with the line-out. Picked up by Watling of Dulwich. Into the 22 they come. Thompson, War, Berry, and Zigwu. Good tackle from Jonty Thornton. Thompson. War. Berry. Chuck to be a chance here for Henderson. Watling, 5 metres out. Thompson spots the gap himself. Does he stay strong? Just a metre or so short. De Rome. War, Berry, Henderson, and Zigo, awkward bounce, Malik. Good tackle from Luke White. But Dulwich got reinforcements to try and help him. Thompson. War. War spots a gap. And John Ward is over. War, what is he good for? The opening try for Dulwich. That's what he is, under the post. And Dulwich back in the game.
Well, great response from Dulwich. I thought the chance had gone when there was that incredible try-saving tackle over in the left-hand corner as Dulwich attacked the line, but they kept their patience, they kept going. And what about that for a finish from John War? Let's take a look at this again. Good ball from Pierre Thompson. War gets it, dummies inside, puts the hammer down and leaves the Bromsgrove defence for dead. Game on.
Simple conversion taken by John War. 3-point game, 10-7 Bromsgrove lead. We have 11 minutes to play in this first half. Yeah, John War spotted the gap there, lovely. Drop that under the post. 10-7, we have 10 and a half minutes or so left to play. 11 minutes on the stadium clock. Yeah. A good response from Dulwich.
Yeah, fantastic response from Dulwich. Bromsgrove, they've defended really well, but they'll be disappointed with that. It was a great finish from Ward, but he did have a lot of space to run into. Oh, that's a wonderful take,
wonderful
from the kickoff, though.
Wonderful take in the kickoff from Joe Morris. Came out of nowhere. And this is the response Bromsgrove will be looking for. Henry Walker. Parisi. And he spots a little bit of a gap as well. Offload didn't happen, though, for Jonty Thornton, and there's a knock-on advantage to come here for Dulwich, which will now be over, no doubt. Pinnock on the chase. Picked up by Cooper Bent. And it's a penalty to Bromsgrove in roughly the same area Luke White scored his first one from. Do you think he fancies chances again?
Well, it'll be a good kick from there. Dulwich had an advantage there. They kicked it away. They scrambled the kick away. Could have kept hold of it.
It's a relatively simple kick for John Wall. Just to give you confirmation, it is a 10-7 game.
Well, you say relatively simple, but all of the points count. So often we see that missed kicks can make a huge, huge amount of difference. And it looks as though Bromsgrove are going to go for the sticks here.
This, yeah, indeed, both touch judges have come underneath the post, so it's a kick here for Luke White.
Well, it would be an excellent kick from here and a brilliant response following that period of sustained Dulwich pressure and, of course, the try. He'd be 3 from 3 then for the match.
Alex Nisbet just leaving the field for Bromsgrove. This will be an excellent kick from White to give him a 6-point advantage. This for a 6-point lead. He'll get there. It's got the legs. Has he got the line right this time? No. And Dulwich are running it from their own try line. Malik goes to ground. Thompson with the box kick in field, Watling under it. Ooh, ball went backwards, says the referee, and Thompson is in midfield with it. Excellent offload to Watling. Ball goes backwards, says the referee once more. Ed Berry. They need reinforcements on the right-hand side. We could be outnumbered here. Instead, War spots a gap in towards the 22. Not a bad kick. Thornton under pressure. He's got two men around him and an excellent tackle from his opposite number, Omar Malik. And they win the penalty as well for holding on. John Wall there with the kick. I thought at the time it was the wrong decision. They may get 3 points out of this, or maybe a couple more, Dave.
Yeah, and James Taylor, the Bromsgrove fullback, he's limping back as well. Feeling the after effects of that collision with Tom Watling going for that up and under.
And Dulwich smell blood.
Yeah, it was an excellent kick. Putting Bromsgrove under pressure in the right areas of the field. Holds on for too long, forces the penalty, and what a position Dulwich are in now.
Richard Derome with the line-out.
Will we see one of the driving mauls that they were so successful with in the semi-final? Here it comes.
Good call, Dave. But Bromsgrove will remain strong, maybe not. Here comes the drive from Dulwich. The Dulwich drive, keep your eye on the back. The referee spots another penalty.
Well, the referee's signal, they pulled it down there. So Bromsgrove treading on thin ice here.
Well, same again, please, I think, Dave.
Well, when it's executed well, it's completely undefendable. We've already seen Bromsgrove march 20 metres up the field. But this time it's Dulwich, 5 metres from the Bromsgrove try line.
To Rome, same again, please. That's what they're looking for. Here's the drive again. And it will be Bromsgrove with the putting. Didn't work this time around.
No, that's a huge let off for Bromsgrove. They have got every right to pat themselves on the back for escaping that without conceding a try. Chance goes begging that time for Dulwich. But still a lot of work to do here for Bromsgrove.
6 minutes left to play. Just interestingly enough, we can see one of the Bromsgrove players just receiving a little bit of treatment underneath the goalposts. So Bromsgrove have got to hope that they win this scrum. They're cutting their man down at the moment. It might be the fullback, James Taylor.
Yeah, following that collision where there was a big collective groan from the audience there. A few lads having a good time. Look, with Tom Watling, they ran it for the same up and under. Watling got straight up and on with it, but I think Taylor knocked the wind out of his sails a bit. Yeah, he's limping off. He is not happy at all. And he sits down to get some medical attention as they bring in a replacement fullback.
Scrum down. Bromsgrove ball. Parisi with the putting. Good scrum from Bromsgrove, picked up by number 8 Tom Ford. Parisi with the box kick. Thompson under it, knocks it backwards, passes in the best zone, puts Malik under pressure, but he does well, beats one man and another and continues to go, and a good off and a good handoff as well. Malik is up and running. Two handoffs and he's still going. It takes two men to get him down. Thompson spots a gap. Watling. Thompson. War. Berry. Pinnock. And Zigu, this is into the 22. Excellent tackle from Harley Ferguson. Thompson, War, looking for a second try. Offload is there, And it is, no, the ball was knocked forward from George Wichelow. Dulwich is celebrating. It shouldn't be. It's going to be a scrum down, Bromsgrove ball.
Yeah, great work again from John Waugh, though. Just drops that shoulder, finds the gap, gets the offload away, but it goes to ground. Credit to Dulwich, though. They're really starting to apply some pressure after that magnificent Bromsgrove start to the match.
A little bit forward pass.
Yeah, Luke Bliss there, the second rower, just trying to release the hands. The ball goes to ground. Chance goes begging again.
Well, it's been a breathless first half. Bromsgrove have been mightily impressive. Resistance to the Dulwich empire, as it were. Picked up by Tom Ford. Parisi with the kick. Spins this time around and a couple of players under it. And has come back into Dulwich hands with their number 8, Tom Martin, their captain. And they have a penalty as well. Options here. It's a relatively straightforward kick, Dave.
Yeah, it's in John Waugh's hands. He's pointed to the sticks. I think that's a sensible decision. They plugged the corner last time from a similar place and came unstuck, came away with no points.
I think they've got one eye on the clock as well. There's only 2 and a bit minutes left to play, so getting towards the end of this first half, and if that's the case, we might as well have a level game going into the second half.
Well, after the start that Bromsgrove had, I think Dulwich should take 10 all at this stage.
John Waugh, all the Dulwich's points have come from him so far, with one try, one conversion, and now one penalty. 10-10, the score, level match in this cup final.
Yeah, good kick from Waugh, good pressure from Dulwich. And now the Bromsgrove response, it's over to them, very much so. They look comfortable at 10-0, but you can never write off a team that's undefeated in any competition. And boy, oh boy, is this evenly poised now.
Exciting, isn't it? Sent downfield and collected by Tom Marchant.
Charlie D has taken Joe Morris out off the ball there. I don't think it was deliberate, but that's a great tackle in midfield.
Excellent tackle it was by Beck Cutting, who's had a good game so far for Bromsgrove.
But either way, Morris definitely felt that and he wasn't particularly happy about it.
Thompson. Waugh sends this downfield into the hands of Tom Ford. Ford. Blake Edwards. And a nice decent offload that was to Jonty Thornton. Parisi, White, with an advantage to come, so it could be an opportunity here for Bromsgrove to take the lead into half-time. Parisi, White, Beck Cutting, Parisi, White, offload to Ferguson. But they are going to come back for that penalty. And now with, 6 seconds left to go on the stadium clock, got to go for post here, Dave.
Yeah, I think so. They've got a good goal kicker. He's certainly got the range. He's kicked a few good goals already. This is a great way to respond after all this Dulwich pressure as well. They would dearly love to go in at half-time with a lead, no matter how narrow.
It's about, I would say, 27, 28 metres, well within his kicking range, Luke White, and this to give Bromsgrove the lead at half-time. It's spinning, but it's over. Bromsgrove will lead at half-time in this under-18s NatWest Cup final. They lead by 13 points to 10 over the three-time defending champions, Dulwich College. Bromsgrove, Dave, have been excellent.
Bromsgrove, superb at times. Dulwich, superb at times. This is exactly what you want from the crown jewel of school rugby. Bromsgrove flew out of the blocks, looked for all the world like they could run away with it, but never write Dulwich off. Their response was exceptional. John Waugh has led from that number 10 jersey. Great try, he's kicked two goals. But Luke White there has just popped Bromsgrove back in the lead, and they'll be absolutely delighted with that opening 35 minutes, will the Midlanders.
Indeed they will be. They lead Dulwich College. Just to remind you, Dulwich have never lost in this competition in the 4 years they've been in it. They're under the cosh at the moment. 13-10, they trail at half-time. Bromsgrove, deservedly, Dave, on the lead, I think it's deservedly so.
I think so. Both teams have had their periods of pressure in that first half. Bromsgrove certainly set their stall out, but Dulwich were their own worst enemy at times. They didn't make particularly good decisions in midfield. They didn't kick well to begin with. But all of a sudden, John Moore and Pierre Thompson, they started working as a half-back unit a bit better. It started off with Pierre Thompson, a few little grubber kicks. Then John Moore followed his lead. Then he scored that fantastic try, did the outside half, dropped the shoulder. As I'm looking up now and seeing Bongo can't take it first. That's one of my favourite. It's one of my favourites at any...
In fact, they've got Ben Youngs doing it at the moment, but I'm just looking at the stats here at the moment of the last three finals of the Under 18s club. Dulwich beat Old Swinford Hospital 15 points to 8. They beat Northampton 27 points to 17. That was a lot closer, that game, than from what I recall, than what it was on paper. Last year it was a horse race. It was Dulwich 53 points to 5 against Warwick School. This is their toughest test they've been in the 4 years, it really has been. So it should be really, really intriguing how they respond in the second half.
Yes, both outside halves having a huge part to play at the moment, as we thought they would. As I spoke about before, John Waugh's try, absolutely fantastic, but Luke White himself going through some real work. Not necessarily having the opportunity to break the line, but he's kicked intelligently. He's not been scared to use, to sort of go against the grain of the play. If it looks like it's going left, he's not been scared to kick right just to try and find a little bit of territory somewhere. So Battle of the Tens in the second half will be very interesting indeed.
Let's very quickly look at the try so far in this game.
Well, this was the first try, sustained period of pressure early on through Bromsgrove. The forwards working well together, second row to second row. That's one for the engine room club that is finished in the end by Beck Cutting after a lovely ball from his second row partner, Justin Clegg. That was what they deserved at that time, though, you know. They had a great start, Bromsgrove. They kicked the penalty as well, and they led 10-0. At which point, it was all about the Dulwich response, and they came back exactly as we expected them to. They found territory. They were patient. When it looked like the opportunity was gone, all of a sudden, there's that moment of magic. John Waugh, dummies inside, dummies outside, steps off the right foot. This will be a really, really good angle to see the way he opens up the defence here. Lovely ball from Pierre Thompson. There you go, he looks inside there. He's got a man as the inside option, but instead, bang, he steps off the right foot, dabs down under the sticks. He's kicked a penalty as well, and Luke White, of course, kicked that penalty at the end to make it 13-10 to Bromsgrove.
Indeed, that is where we stand right now in this Under-18s Cup final. 13 points to 10, Bromsgrove lead against Dulwich College. What do you think both coaches will be saying to their teams at half?
Well, both teams will want to impose themselves right at the beginning of this second half. Dulwich, as you pointed out at the time, just did not get off the bus. And Bromsgrove certainly did. In terms of patterns of play, I think it's gonna be a lot of the same. There's gonna be a lot of tackles going in the midfield. I think it's going to be a case of who can secure the best ball in the best areas of the field and then capitalise on that. Also, patience is key. You're not just going to run through these defences. They're incredibly organised 15s, both of them. You've got to hammer away at that door and almost blast it down at times.
Well, Dulwich have been given their marching orders. They're already ready for kick-off. Bromsgrove, 35 minutes away from creating a little bit of history here themselves. So then, 35 minutes away between one of these two teams and Cup Glory, as Dave said, in the crown jewels of schools rugby. The Dulwich College, they want their dynasty and their empire to continue here. They need to pull something out of a hat, because they really are given a stern examination from a very strong Bromsgrove team. Underway. Ed Berry with the restart. And good intent from Dulwich College as we start the second half. Parisi with the box kick downfield. John Waugh under it. Waugh to Nzugu. Good tackle from Justin Clegg. Thompson. Waugh. Offload was tried there for Malik, but was knocked forward, and Bromsgrove will have the put in.
Good intent again from Waugh. He's got that sort of ability that loads of excellent tens have, where they're able to drop the shoulder, absorb the contact, and still get the offload away. I mean, that time it didn't quite come off, it was knocked forward. But if you're a winger, then maybe you should be picking up on that and just sort of sticking around on his shoulder, because the opportunities to score will definitely come.
Parisi with the put in. Awkward for Parisi, but he does well. White with his right boot sends this one high into the sky. Rhys Pinnock is under it. Pinnock, he's found a gap, and he's off and running. But one man to beat, and he's very quick, and it's a good tackle from White to stop Pinnock in his tracks. He was in for the corner then, Rhys Pinnock, but still could be here for Dulwich. Thompson, Waugh, De Rome. Thompson, Berry. Bliss. Thompson trips, carries on with possession in hand. Charlie D. Penalty advantage coming Dulwich's way. Thompson high into the sky for John Waugh. Bit of a juggling act, and it came out in Tom Martin's hands. Thompson. Bliss. Driving forward. They're over the line. Are they down? It might have been held up. Has been held up. But they're going to come back for the earlier penalty.
Yeah, big decision there from the referee. He was in the right place at the right time. Bromsgrove there being shouted into position by a few loud voices in defence, but excellent start to the half from Bromsgrove. This is a brilliant angle. Oh, well done, the Bromsgrove defence.
Saved themselves 4 points there at least.
But credit to Dulwich, that's an excellent start to the half.
Indeed, but still three to come. They concede a penalty in the early part of those phases.
Yeah, fantastic break up the left wing by Rhys Pinnock, the hat-trick hero, of course, in the semi-final.
Level game, 13 points apiece. 13 points coming from John Waugh in this game. 8 from his boots, 5 from his arms. 13 points all. We have around a half an hour to play.
Yes, that all came from Rhys Pinnock. Great work from the left winger. Beat a few tackles. He's so quick. And he puts those little movements on as he's going into contact as well. Makes him an absolute nightmare to tackle. From then on, Dulwich just carried on applying the pressure. They had the penalty advantage. The up and under didn't quite come off. but the penalty certainly did. 13-all, beautifully poised final.
13 points apiece, Dulwich win a penalty. A chance to gain possession from inside the Bromsgrove half, maybe, or towards the halfway line. Wall with the kick. And does gain some good yards from it too as well, up towards the halfway line in fact. Richard de Rome. Patient line-out, which is collected by Sam Younger. Watling. Running stuff here from Dulwich College. Henderson. Thompson. Akise Clifford. Thompson. War, Berry, Henderson, Malik. Ball was turned over, but illegally.
Well, following the half-time break, Dulwich look absolutely rejuvenated, don't they?
Well, look how players possessed here, don't they?
Beautiful angle, look at that, splitting the two defenders there. Just lost his footing, but fantastic line there run by the substitute.
Into touch, this one goes, and into the Bromsgrove 22. Bromsgrove are playing against a different Dulwich team, it seems here, Dave.
Oh,
in the
yes.
Second half.
Absolutely, big test of the defence here. They held out the driving maul twice in the first half. See if Dulwich can mix up the tactics this time.
Richard de Rome, picked up by Justin Clegg, but done so illegally, and it's going to be a scrum down Bromsgrove ball.
That's a couple of times now Dulwich have had an opportunity, really good attacking line out. Three times they've blown it, they'll be disappointed with that.
Points apiece, half an hour to play. Just to remind you, if it is a tie, it goes on the number of tries scored, and if that's a tie, it's the number of goals to come from tries, number of conversions. And right now, if it is, both teams would share the trophy. Parisi, downfield. And that ball has been sent backwards, and a little bit of trouble here for Parisi. It's a bit of a scrap fest. They want to try and find this ball, and so much so, Dulwich win the penalty. Shot a goal here, Dave? Shot to nothing, maybe?
Well, we said that Dulwich College needed to show some composure in the first half, and they did. Bromsgrove really need to now. They need to soak up this period of Dulwich pressure, because it is absolutely relentless. And as you said there, the shot at goal was probably the wise decision, but Dulwich really, really fancy it. They've spurned three opportunities from lineouts in these positions.
So Richard DeRome, does he have his arrows back this one? How's his dart this time? It's scrappy, but they collect from Charlie D. Now the drive, the Dulwich drive. They have a penalty to come, but they want more. Luke Bliss in his left arm. Driving forward, continuing to drive. They continue, they're going, it's patient, it's good stuff from Dulwich College. Thompson wants it, but they might go himself with Bliss, all the way down, he's there, a superbly worked try from Dulwich College. They have the lead in this cup final. Luke Bliss is the scorer, patience is a virtue. They lead 18 points to 13.
Well, it was absolutely perfectly executed this time. Fourth time the charm, as it were. They've tried it before as the fans through the Poznan and face away from the pitch. It was a ballsy decision to go for the corner, and they did, but they've executed it with aplomb, set the drive, showed patience, marched forward towards the try line and get their just desserts and the lead.
We'll show it properly in full shortly. John Waugh, this to add the extras and to make them 7 points clear. He's hit the post. That could make a difference. They can kick for goals now, Bromsgrove, if they need to. Drop goals could be in play. Anything could happen here now. But excellently worked there from Bliss, wasn't it? Just superbly worked try.
Just always in full control. He was in control of the ball. Bromsgrove can't get anywhere near the ball carrier. As long as he stays bound to the mall, then he can go as far as he wants. Well played, Dulwich. They lead for the first time.
Luke White with the restart. Thompson, surveying his options, uses the box kick, charged down, but collected by John Wall. Thompson, take two, does better with his second attempt. White spots the gap on the right side of the field, and his kick is excellent, up towards the 22.
Yeah, excellent kick. He was under pressure, actually. There was a good chase on White's box kick, but he's managed to nurse the ball back into the Dulwich 22. Bromsgrove will be hoping to disrupt this line-up, build a bit of momentum of their own, because in the opening, 11 minutes of the second half, it has been all Dulwich College, and the scoreline reflects that.
Good take it was from Tom Ford, and a good kick from Luke White. Dulwich collect the line-out. At the back with Luke Bliss. Thompson. Berry. Excellent offload to Henderson. Thompson. John Waugh. Kick should remain in field, but the bounce could be awkward, and it certainly was awkward for Cooper Bent. But he wants to go for a little darting run himself and trying to launch the counter-attack for Bromsgrove, trying to get this team going. Parisi with the box kick. Off into the air. Taken by John Waugh. Goes to ground immediately. Thompson. Box kick. It's a deep one too. Up towards the Bromsgrove 22, and a good take it was from Chase Edwards. And the chase is on right now. He spots a little bit of a gap going through midfield, and he stays strong, does well, gains the yards. Luke White. Blake Edwards. Tibbetts on the field. Advantage to be played here for Bromsgrove. So they're able to kick some distance here if nothing comes from this phase of play. Tibbetts. White. And stopped in their tracks by our referee, Christoph Ridley, and they're able to gain some territory from this.
Yeah, the penalty was given for offside. There was a Dulwich player lying on the wrong side, and the scrum half's pass bounced off him. Bit better from Bromsgrove in the last couple of minutes. Just a few of their big ball carriers starting to make incisions. Unfortunately for them, in the wrong areas of the field. having to work hard to run the ball out of their own half. But that's a pretty decent touch finding it out. Back into the Dulwich 22, and this time with the throw-in.
Dulwich 22 indeed. And they have the line-up this time. It's been a while since Henry Walker's had the ball in hand on the touchline. Still loads of time in this game, 20 minutes to play.
Well, it's a long way to the try line from here, but Bromsgrove have already driven 20 or 25 metres up the field with one of those mauls. But
they need to get it, but the referee not too happy, and it's going to be a free kick to Bromsgrove.
Well, decision's been made here, and they're opting for the scrum.
So obviously they're confident with their pack.
Well, they're confident with the pack. They're also confident with the backs, and with the ball over that side of the field, certainly does allow more space for the danger runners.
Ben Tibbetts. To put in the scrum for Bromsgrove. We haven't seen much attacking intent from the Midland school in the second half, and nearly was in there for Blake Edwards. Tibbetts, Justin Clegg, with an advantage to come, penalty advantage, and they will get that penalty if the tackler not rolling away. Thompson doesn't release, but I'm sure now, well, it's interesting decision here, Dave. 20 minutes to play, right in front of the post.
Has to be sticks, surely. Yes, it is.
Plenty of time for a chance of another score here. This is a real test for Dulwich to go for a fourth consecutive crown. Only one other school has done that in the past. Bromsgrove are really, really giving them a tough examination here to Twickenham. Luke White, this is his fourth kick out of four for the day. Straight over, no problem.
This is exciting stuff, and that's a good decision. They're an unconverted score behind, so there's always the temptation when you're in that area in the field to call for the scrum or run the ball or whatever, but that is three free points. There's bags of time to go.
18 minutes to play, in fact. Bromsgrove 16, Dulwich 18. Ed Betty with the restart. Referee said that was fair. Thompson. Picked up by Shimerund. Parisi. Up into the air. Malik. Put to ground. Thompson. Picked up. Still in Dulwich hands. But their number 22, Chris Annoy. Thompson. John Wall. Omar Malik. Thundering tackle by Harrison Fouke.
Physicality's definitely gone up a notch in the last minute or so. Bromsgrove really putting it about here.
Thompson.
And again.
And again, they're really putting the tackles in here now. An excellent one there from Joe Morris. They're up for this. Really are up for it. And they have a penalty to come as well. They're holding on. and the Dulwich school pupils in the other side of the ground are up on their feet. They're sensing something here, Dave.
Well, Bromsgrove, high fives all round there. That's a massive 2 minutes of defence. The defence has been consistent throughout this match, but all of a sudden they've stepped it up a notch. Big hits, dump tackles, really driving the opposition back. And it's amazing how excited the supporters can get about a period of play in the midfield. And that's an excellent kick too. Omar Malik thought he was going to snaffle that one. Let's take a look at that.
Well, Bromsgrove here had more hits than Elvis. It was a superb set of defensive play here, Dave, wasn't it?
Wonderful. Front rowers there driving into the tackles. Joe Morris as well, the flanker, really putting in a shift.
...15 minutes to play. Morris collects. Now they set up the driving maul again. Here comes the drive. In the back, Ben Schumann. He's lost the ball though, and it's been knocked forward. Opportunity wasted.
Yeah, let off there for Dulwich in terms of the knock-on, but brilliant, brilliant counter drive. We've seen how dangerous that Bromsgrove maul can be. Dulwich read the situation, committed numbers, and it's paid dividends because they escaped what was a very, very precarious situation.
Well, a couple of players just seeing a little bit of treatments, one player's just doing his laces. It's all happening. Plenty of time.
Well, the stadium clock says just under 15 minutes remaining. Time back on now. I get the impression there are many, many twists and turns to come in this remaining quarter of an hour or so.
Well, we mentioned in one of the games earlier, this could take a flash of brilliance or an ounce of stupidity could actually decide this game. And an excellent scrum there from Bromsgrove. Excellent scrum there from Bromsgrove to put Dulwich under pressure here. So they go again. Dulwich put him. Bromsgrove fans on their feet. We've got their banners raised. And this time, another good scrum from Bromsgrove. But they'll have to put in once more, Dulwich.
Well, the clock's ticking here. We've been just coming up to 2 minutes with this scrum, which will suit Dulwich. You know, they do, of course, have the lead, but it is a very, very, very narrow one. They'll be desperate to get out of their own 22.
A precarious lead. Thompson out. Malik beats Tibbetts. That's as far as he goes though. Charge down! Didn't fall the way of Henry Walker, but it's put into touch and Dulwich just relieved a little bit of pressure. It will be Bromsgrove with the line out on the 22.
Well, that's twice now. Bromsgrove have managed to charge down the kick. Not quite able to capitalise on it though. Joe Morris, typical open side flanker, pouncing on anything and everything he can. Decent relieving kick at the end, but now a real chance for Bromsgrove with the throw in at the line out inside the 22. Big, big, big moments in this under-18s Cup final.
Omar Malik just receiving some treatment on the sidelines. The clock has been stopped as well, so... I And we started so. Walker. Collected by Clegg. And now the drive is coming again in the hands of Beck Cutting at the back. Continuing to drive. They're still a good few yards out. Beck Cutting. They continue to go forward and forward and forward. That'll be a penalty. Been brought down. Bombs are looking for a little bit more. Chase Edwards. Walker. Tibbetts, White, needed to go round. Could be a chance here in the corner. And there's a chance for keeper Bent, but it's not going to be a try. They're going to come back for an earlier penalty.
What an opportunity there for Bromsgrove. Brilliant last gasp defence. Forcing their hand with Dulwich with that drift defence. Forcing the knock on. The danger is not clear yet, but this is an excellent shift from Dulwich. But a line out now 5 metres out. Let's have a little look at this. Just probing away Bromsgrove. Asking questions. Here it goes wide. Rushing our defence. It was a bit of a hospital pass. Chase Edwards tried to release it quickly, but the ball had gone forward. Good spot from the referee, but he went back for the original penalty. Big, big trouble here for Dulwich.
Big trouble indeed. Bromsgrove in relentless. Now the drive will come again. Tibbetts, White, crossfield kick. Cooper Bent there. Is he there? Catches it. He's over. Cooper Bent. A score for Bromsgrove. They take the lead with 11 minutes left to play. They're the ones now with the advantage. 3 points clear. The Dulwich dynasty could be dethroned here at Twickenham. Dulwich lead 21 points to 18.
Well, we thought they were going to go for the drive. Scrappy, but what fantastic vision from the captain. Luke White spots his left winger Cooper Bent in acres of space over on the right hand side. Pinpoint accurate kick into Bent's breadbasket, and he finishes unopposed. Let's have a look at this again. Glorious kick, absolutely inch and weight perfect. No one anywhere near Cooper Bent. It's a great catch, but he will not score an easier try at Twickenham. What a time to score.
Massive kick this. Massive kick for Luke White. This could send him 5 points clear with 10 minutes to play. Big moment in this game. He did a pin drop here at Twickenham. He could have put it, he's at the post. Or has he slid it in? He has slid it in. Oh, he's looking at right for the post. It was. It's slid it off the post. And now Bromsgrove, 23 points to 18, they lead. 5 points clear. 9 minutes, 45 seconds left to play. Dulwich with a roll to do.
Well, we're on our feet here in the commentary position now. What a way to end the NatWest Schools Cup. We've had three brilliant matches, but this is the pick of the bunch.
Ball put into touch. Now, Dave, do Dulwich have what it takes to get back into this game?
Well, they certainly have the ability. They have the talent, they have the players. Do they have the mentality? Oh, this game has ebbed and flowed so much. It's gone from moments where it looked as though Bromsgrove would win. Then Dulwich could possibly pull away, but neither team has been able to really, really dominate this match.
Thompson, Norris, Wall. Onoi. Reece Pinnock. Chip forward. And it's been taken by Inouye. It could be in. It's gone scrappy and loose. Ed Norris with it. Cross field. That's the bounce. It's gone out. And it will be a Bromsgrove line out. I'm just looking at the scores here, Dave, and I'm looking at the score on the top left of the screen, 23-18. A try for Dulwich, just a try, is good enough. It is good enough because the tiebreak will be judged on tries scored. They will have three to Bromsgrove's two. Not sure if that's been sent out to the players, but a try is good enough for Dulwich to win this if it's a draw right now. Three tries to Dulwich if they scored a try to two of Bromsgrove's. So then, 5.5 minutes to go. And it's a big, big scrum going Dulwich's way, 5 metres out. Thompson with the putting. Thompson, knocked forward from Omar Malik, and a chance here for Bromsgrove to break. We've got players as well, and they're off and running, but not the races, and Leicester put the game to bed. Leicester set the cup back to the Midlands. A good run it was from Chase Edwards. Blake Edwards collects, Tibbins, Tom Ford. Ball taken cleanly, Thompson has lost it and has been knocked forward, and Bromsgrove will have the put in. 6 minutes to go on the stadium clock.
What a break from Chase Edwards. The ball got knocked forward off a Dulwich hand, and instead of stopping and waiting for the scrum, Chase Edwards just picked up the ball and ran. He didn't quite have the gas to get there, but what a way to relieve the pressure on your team. As we reach the dying embers of this game, what a finish we have set up. But Chase Edwards, what a moment to just unleash. Great work from the Bromsgrove 13.
Breathless stuff, been breathless. Chase Edwards must have thought he was in. He had a man to his left-hand side in Cooper Bent. He was quick, but not quick enough, and that would have put this game to bed.
Yeah, it was a brilliant cover tackle by the substitute, Anous. Had to have his wits about him, showed great pace himself, because Chase Edwards was at full throttle there down the right-hand side.
Six minutes to play, 5 minute game. So then, Bromsgrove with the put in. Tibbetts has it, sending it to the left hand side. Blake Edwards. Edwards with a run. This is it! This is it for Bromsgrove! They're on there! They're on there! Bromsgrove with a try! 5.5 minutes to play! The NatWest Cup could be headed to the Midlands, and the Dulwich dynasty could be dethroned. It could be all over for the three-time champions. Bromsgrove have been brilliant so far. 28 points to 18 in lead. 5.5 minutes to go. They've been rampant in the second part of this second half.
Well, centres absolutely dream of this at Twickenham. 30 metres to go. They get the ball at full tilt. Sense a hint of a gap and just pin their ears back for the line. That was a glorious finish by the substitute, Blake Edwards. And it is a long, long way back for Dulwich now. Wonderful moment of brilliance from the number 22.
Even more of a long way back if this one goes over. This for a 30 points to 18 lead. don't need me to tell you where that one's gone. Into the heart, Luke White, six kicks from six, he's had a superb game. Bromsgrove are 4 minutes, 10 seconds away from picking up this NatWest trophy. 30 points to 18 they lead. What a game we've had here. What a game. Parisi picks it up. Just out of interest, Dave, myself and my producer were having breakfast this morning whilst you were on your way down. We tried to name all four winners, and at the moment, we've got all four of them wrong. Binnick. I do beg your pardon, you got the second one right. I do beg your pardon. I think I've got all four of them wrong. Is there a sting in the tail to come? Could possibly be. And Louis. Not Ed Norris now. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll have a grandstand finish if Dulwich can find a try here. They've knocked it forward, but they have a penalty. Take tap and go. Thompson is off and running.
It's got to go.
Got to go. He goes to the right hand side now. It could be in. It could be in here in the corner. Is it going to be a chance here for the Zugu?
Great cover defence from Bromsgrove. It had to go quicker
Thompson.
Than that.
Ed Waugh, John Ward, I beg your pardon. Gone out and loose, and it's been turned over, but penalty time and go again. Thompson is up and running. Thompson, 3 metres out. And Bunk dunked into touch. Superb game, it's been 2 minutes 20 to go. And it will be line out, Bromsgrove ball. David, your man of the match, please.
Incredible performances all around the pitch. This is one of the best games of rugby I've ever witnessed in my life, to be honest. But that man on your screen right there, Luke White, the captain of Bromsgrove, wearing number 10. He's kicked fantastically, both from the tee and out of hand. He's made things tick, and ultimately, he has orchestrated a magnificent Bromsgrove school performance that could be just enough to see them crowned champions.
2 minutes 11 on the clock in the stadium. That was just a rough indication. And one of the Bromsgrove coaching staff is just having a little bit of a word with the touch judges. Not sure what that was about, but no doubt we'll have a conference about that later. In the meantime, Walker with the line-out, collected by Joe Morris. Dulwich need to pull a rabbit out of a hat here from somewhere. And Bromsgrove will have the penalty, which they'll take an eternity to take.
Yeah, fantastic defence from Bromsgrove again. It's been an absolute pleasure to watch this game today. Two incredibly talented teams have given it absolutely everything. Bromsgrove started really well. Dulwich came back and looked for all the world like they could do enough to win this game. But we talked about moments of magic, didn't we? And towards the latter part of this second half, Bromsgrove have pulled a couple of absolute rabbits out of the hat. And should they do enough with, well, what, 1 minute 16 seconds left on the stadium clock, they will certainly be worthy winners. A wonderful, wonderful performance.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Morris collects on the line-out. A wonderful performance it has been from Bromsgrove. And the man looking to add the icing on the cake. And this drive has been their main weapon of their arsenal. But a penalty has been conceded. Time is massively running out here for Dulwich College. So much so that they said the chase is on here for one of the players to try and go for. Well, scrum five. Ball was taken over the line, but they're on the time to take it. 25 seconds left. not going to get two tries now, even if the game restarts. What a game he is in. Comes on the scrum half. Driving forward from Dulwich, but this will be it. Into touch it goes. And the Dulwich dynasty is over. All hail the new Canes. They come from the Midlands. They've been brilliant. They are Bromsgrove. They are the winners of the Under-18s NatWest Cup. Three teams have tried to defeat Dulwich College in this competition, but every one of them has failed. But this Bromsgrove side, with that driving pack, the driving ball, were too strong from the school for South London. The three times champions have been humbled here at Twickenham. Bromsgrove, take a bow. You absolutely deserve it. You are the winners of the NatWest Under-18s Cup. They've defeated the three-time defending champions, Dulwich College, by 30 points to 18. What a performance.
What a performance indeed. As I said just a couple of minutes ago, it's been an absolute privilege to be here. These two teams have put on an incredible display today. I've not enjoyed a rugby match like that for such a long time. It had everything. It had physical power. It had finesse, it had individual brilliance, it had some great tries, it had some brilliant decision making. I mean, both outside halves have been absolutely wonderful. John Waugh kicked well, scored that excellent try. Luke White, we awarded him the man of the match, but it could have been him or any number of players. But he too, he kicked well. He's got an excellent rugby brain, you know, he moved the play around to the areas of the field where it needed to be at that particular time. If he had to change direction, he changed direction. If he had to bring it in the forwards, if he had to bring backs into play. What about that try by the replacement as well? Blake Edwards to put the final nail in the coffin. Superb finish. Great pace, great strength from over 30 metres out. We have been absolutely treated in this Under-18s Cup final. Brilliant, brilliant rugby match.
Absolutely, it's been enthralling. All day has been enthralling. We've had four magnificent matches here at Twickenham today. Four magnificent games of rugby. Bromsgrove School, which has been home to Ben Foden, Andy Good and Matt Mullen in the past. One or two of these players you may see wearing the England jersey in the future. I will be honest with you, I didn't think Bromsgrove had enough in the tank to defeat Dulwich. In all fairness, they surpassed my expectations of them and more. They have been phenomenal for me, the performance of the day.
Well, you wonder how much psychology plays in any match, let alone a cup final at Twickenham. And Dulwich and their records and their ability, they're just so imposing. They've just had a stranglehold on this competition for the last three seasons. Well, four seasons, if you count their flawless route to the final. But Bromsgrove just cast all that to one side, threw caution to the wind and just put in a performance. That was a squad of 22 at the top of their game today. They did not leave anything to chance. And that's a brilliant performance. Well done, Bromsgrove School. Well done.
Congratulations to our runners-up, Dulwich College, who go up the stairs to collect their runners-up medals. Led by their captain, Tom Marchant. Up the stairs to collect the runners-up medals. But let's chat about Bromsgrove. Beck Cutting opened the scoring for Bromsgrove with his first try. Luke White was, I mentioned him in the first half, an architect. And I think that's the best way to describe it, an architect for this victory.
Well, very often outside halves, they're kind of credited with all the flash stuff that they do. But if you go right up to the test level, you know, outside halves are the people who actually make things happen as opposed to it happening to them directly, you know? And an architect is, or a conductor of the orchestra, They make the right decisions at the right times, and he certainly did. A few of the biggest plays in this match, not necessarily the ones that directly resulted to points, but just the ones that got the momentum going in Bromsgrove's way. They're just starting to make their way towards the tunnel. They can see the trophy. Yes, Luke White, wonderful, wonderful day for him. A gold medal, a trophy, and a man of the match award at Twickenham Stadium. Doesn't get a lot better than that, does it?
It's definitely a turning topic. Dulwich, don't. Right, I'm off. They'll be back. No doubt in my mind, they'll be back. They've got three. They're still chasing Colston's seven. Not their day, but it's the day for the team in maroon. And look at them going up the stairs. Grins like Cheshire Cats.
Absolutely, even the war wounded.
Superb, absolutely superb. They'll watch this back with aplomb, no doubt. Rightly deserved. You know, I can't fault them. That defensively they were brilliant. Attacking, that drive of theirs, which we saw at the Alliance Park day, we thought knew was their trump card, the biggest weapon of their arsenal, and they used it to great effect.
And from start to finish, really. It was a wonderful cup final performance, because we know these matches, they're always going to ebb and flow. There are always going to be times where you're on the front foot. There are always going to be times when you're on the back foot. And I mean, Dulwich, they started the second half impeccably. Came from behind, got eight unanswered points. But then it was almost like a switch flicked for Bromsgrove, wasn't it? All of a sudden, they really put the hammer down in defence. There were those three or four monster hits in midfield. And that was arguably the turning point. That was where they started to get the scoreboard ticking over again. Scored a couple of excellent tries. And now, well, probably less than a minute's time, that trophy's going to go up in the air.
Luke White at the top of the stairs. Just a few more of the replacements just getting their medals from Ben Youngs. Luke White now will receive the trophy. All hail the new Kings. They have got from Bromsgrove, and they have just been simply brilliant. Well done, Bromsgrove, you're the champions! That's what they were in this NatWest Schools Cup final. They were perfect. Their name etched in history. Name etched on the trophy. Trophy. And again, Dave, you know, we were chatting about earlier about in the under-15 bars, a few people writing off the chances against Oakham School. So a few writers I noticed gave Bromsgrove little chance, thought Dulwich would win quite comfortably. Maybe proved wrong as well.
Well, a lot of teams really enjoy the underdog tag, don't they? And Bromsgrove certainly did going into today, but they didn't play like underdogs at all. They played like a confident team who trusted their teammates, who knew their game plan and executed it fantastically well. And now they're at the top of the tree. They're sat on the throne. And it'll be, well, maybe Dulwich next season looking to get their crown back.
Indeed, they're the ones who wear the crown. Now, Bromsgrove score. They're the kings of Twickenham. They are the kings of school rugby for 12 months. But when you are the king, everybody wants your crown.
You certainly are. Just look at those pictures as well. It means the world to those boys. And you've got to think there are some people who have incredible professional rugby careers, play around the world, but they never get to experience this. You know, they never get to experience playing at somewhere like Twickenham, winning a trophy at HQ. Massive, massive moments. Brilliant achievement from Bromsgrove.
They're going to receive the congratulations and cheers from their fellow pupils, families, parents, friends, and everything else. And as you can see, Luke White has just been collected by our reporter Ed Tartan. He's going to be taking him down the tunnel for words with the man of the match, who has been a talisman, Dave.
Oh, fantastic. Absolutely. Matches like this need a leader. And Luke White was the leader, did everything right at the right time. And ultimately, he was the difference between the two teams. Bromsgrove's captain and number 10.
You said when it went right for Bromsgrove, where did it go wrong for Dulwich?
Well, they weren't really able to get their danger runners into the game, were they? You know, they've got two wingers and a fullback who have got so much pace, so much ability, and can score from anywhere, but Bromsgrove managed to stifle those. They couldn't get the quick ball to release that pace, and that's a real weapon in their arsenal they weren't able to take advantage of.
Look at the start of the second half as well. Look at the start of the second half. The way they started, Dulwich, they took the lead. Let's not forget, they took the lead.
Oh, they certainly did. They thought they could snatch this match, but Bromsgrove held strong and lifted the trophy, and that's what matters at this level. Cup final performances, the score is all that matters.
So then, as you saw before, Luke White has been taken to down the tunnel, and hopefully he should be in the tunnel with Ed Tartan.
Congratulations, a fantastic victory, and the spell that was Dulwich College over this cup is broken. How do you feel?
Absolutely incredible. So happy for the boys. You know, Dulwich won it 3 years on the trot, and we knew whatever happened, it was going to be a massive challenge. We're glad we're the school that finally ruined their Dulwich dynasty.
Well, I mean, it was a fantastic performance, probably the best game of rugby of the day, one of the best games of rugby I've seen this year, in fact, in this competition. And one thing I need to ask you is, how do you keep your composure in those key moments? Your kicking game was absolutely exceptional.
Just do the same as what I do in training. So imagine a pole right through the middle and aim for that, and it seems to work in blocking out everyone else.
You talk about the Dulwich dynasty, and that is a very good term for it, to be perfectly honest with you. Were you at all intimidated? Because I spoke to Tony Window at the end of your semi-final, and I said you'd been voted the favourites, and he said, how can we be? We're playing Dulwich.
I think all the boys were the same, you know. They've won it 3 years on the trot, and in our eyes, we saw it as it was theirs to lose. We've done well by getting to the final, and whatever happens now is going to be a positive result, whereas I think for Dulwich, they had a lot of pressure on them. They've won it 3 years, and no team from Dulwich would want to be the team to lose that. So, I think we just came here and just came here to express ourselves, and I think we did it.
And we talk about so many things. We talk about the game, we talk about toppling Dulwich, but one thing I haven't asked you and I need to ask is what it feels like to lead your team out at Twickenham, the home of English rugby, and then to win.
Oh, absolutely incredible. I'm proud with such a tight-knit group, which has really helped us, and leading them out of, I thought leading out of that Saracens' ground was pretty special, and then running out there to thousands of supporters all in maroon and cheering us on is just indescribable.
Well, they gave you fantastic support, and I won't keep you away from those celebrations any longer. Luke, congratulations, fantastic achievement.
Thank
well done.
Thank you very much. Cheers. Thank you very much. Can you just...
Bromsgrove team to victory here at Twickenham. Dave, before we say goodbye, your thought of the day?
Rugby's in a really good place at the moment, isn't it? I mean, just a couple of days ago, we had one of the best days in living memory in the Six Nations Championship. We've come here to Twickenham today, where 80 points were scored. between England and France, and we've seen an absolute festival of junior rugby. We've seen entertainment, we've seen excellent teams play, we've seen brilliant individuals, and ultimately we've seen four new trophy winners. Well, that's got to be great news for the sport, right?
So say all of us. Many thanks to David Rogers, my co-commentator, and to Ed Tarleton at pitchside, and the whole crew here. But the main headline is from today: rugby is the winner, Dulwich have been dethroned, and all hail the new kings of Bromsgrove. From all of us here, thanks for joining us. Bye for now.